an ace broadcaster, seasoned commentator, and prolific writer, late Agunwogo titled one of his books, Betrayed Trust. One of the disciples of Jesus Christ, called Judas Iscariot, betrayed the trust Christ had in him. When God created Adam and Eve, he gave them authority and possession over everything in the Garden of Eden. But in utter defiance of God's commandment, they betrayed the confidence God reposed in them by eating the forbidden fruit. On the other hand, a gentleman is one who lives by his words. It takes guts, courage, and sincerity to be a gentleman. When a politician keeps to his words religiously, not minding whose ox is God, such a politician becomes a rare gem, difficult to understand, difficult to work with in the eyes of those not on the same template with him, difficult to derail or manipulate, and most astonishingly unpredictable. Therefore, when a gentleman in politics finds himself in a strange political alliance with a political neophyte, an imminent confusion occasioned by inexperience and inability to match the dexterity of the principal leads to inevitable loss of direction and inordinate but desperate determination to take a plunge. Like a drowning person, the political apprentice naturally looks for someone to drown with. In his unfortunate state, he wouldn't mind dragging even his shadow to drown with. This, indeed, is the political scenario that played recently in Ebbc State, where a virgin politician, who was the very first appointee of Governor David Nwezo Mahi, after close to 3 years on the saddle, suddenly woke up from slumber and saw nothing good in an administration in which he was actively involved in as the number 4 citizen. Ironically, the same sacked person had in several fora poured encomiums on the same government, which out of genuine concern for all-inclusive and non-sectional governance brought him from another party and another clan and made him what he was, contrary to the old order and practice. When Ebbc State government, under its entrepreneurial governor, engineer Dr. David Nwezo Mahi, unveiled the 4 billion naira Bank of Industry facility, in which the state government contributed 2 billion naira, the sacked professor of geophysics spoke extensively and eruditely of the benefits of the facility to Ebbc citizens. Not to be forgotten in a hurry is the role and contributions of the self-acclaimed lover of Ebbc workers during government workers' negotiation that brought about the current salary package for the workers.
And we are advocating, sir. One of the things we need to do rapidly is our committee on the Bank of Industry, they should rapidly do something quickly and dispose of infrastructure. Let people turn money around. And those who are not understanding what we're saying will begin to see that this thing works. Because there is no how we can liberate ourselves from this poverty. We must do business.
Yeah.
There's no way out of it. I do business myself. But even when I was university, I do business. There's no way you can be comfortable. This salary can't take anybody home. It doesn't work. You know, so I feel for you because as you express this frustration, you express it because as a businessman, you know the link between breaking even and living with poverty. And that's what I think our people have not yet come to realize. You know, so if the committee on our Bank of Industry and government funding, if they're able to do the first disbursement and we follow up with quick action, let that spill the effect of understanding what we're preaching here. Table or no table, anybody who is arguing on this table, it's just a waste of time because this table cannot solve any problem. Even if we increase the salary by 100%, it is still 50,000 naira. Does that solve any problem to this? It doesn't.
Indeed, the vote faced by the sacked secretary to Ebbc State government To now feign to be speaking for workers is nothing but hypocrisy and smokescreen aimed at achieving cheap political popularity while evading obvious inadequacies. The unscathing criticism of a government that cleared arrears of pensions and gratuity from the creation of a Ebonyi state to date speaks volume of the Ontario motive behind the crocodile tears being shed by the sacked SAG. It will be recalled that the same brave man aligned himself with the position of government on the pension matters, yet he claimed that other executive council members who he branded cowards antagonized him because of his outspokenness and bravery. An adage has it that to whom much is given, much is expected. It is not uncanny to fall short of one's expectations and that of the society at large, but it will amount to ingratitude for one to blackmail one's mentor just to curry favor from man and incur the wrath of God. Howbeit, our brother who had lost steam should be pitied rather than being blamed, because no matter how tall, robust, and polished an urban gorilla may be, he needs the tutelage of a village and homegrown farmer to be able to handle the hoe to avoid cutting his toes. This is a clear case of betrayed trust and malicious attempt to derail a fast-moving jet. Certainly, the antics will come to naught. Akobaroha is working, God is watching, and posterity will the better judge. To God be the glory. In Jesus' name, amen.